Good morning, everybody, and welcome to the Glitchcraft server. Yes, it's been a little while, not terribly long. I haven't done much. I did a little bit of building, just for shits and giggles, primarily. It actually started with this building right here. The idea was, the original idea was actually this right here. I wanted to put the sword and the stone on top of the little hill I have here. So it's like, look, sword on the stone kind of, or sword in the stone kind of thing. I don't know. Yeah, but I like the idea, so I took it and kind of ran with it. But I needed to get the chests off that hill, because if you remember, I had all the chests on the hill and in the hill, and obviously I closed that off. So the idea was I would build like a little shop kind of thing to store, you know, flowers and harvestable stuff and saplings and seeds and such. So that was that idea. And then I added the road because I kind of liked that idea, gravel road, with the paths leading up to the doorways. That turned out quite nice, in my opinion. But then I needed a little bit more space because I still had all the other chests on the hill. So I built this little house based off of just those square houses in villages. Boop. And it's just stuffed to the gills with chests and such. So now I have access to a whole bunch of storage for random crap. Boop. And there are a whole shit ton of horses over that way. And I found me a donkey. So I'm going to keep me a donkey. And I decided I wanted to keep him out of the sun, so I built this little, like, I don't know, overhanged kind of stable kind of thing. The idea was that it was going to be just a fabric cover, and it's not pulled completely tight, so it's kind of sagging. It didn't work all that well. But I like it. I'll take it. I'm growing acacia wood there. I'm growing dark wood there just because I like dark oak. I'm growing acacia wood here because I want to get rid of the sheep in the holes that I have over here. Whee! Because they're annoying. And that hole there is just annoying in general. So I'm making a barn over here. And in the process of doing that, I'm going to make a sheep, a wool farm. That's it. Basically a way to infinitely generate wool, and that's what these are. There's going to be 4 sheep per this thing, and a turtle in the center. And that's where we get to today. Is that where we get to today? No, that's where we get to today, because I'm sick and tired of cutting down these trees manually. I have decided to cheat. A little bit. Whee! And by cheat, I don't mean I'm ever going into creative mode. I am not. I am not OP'd on this server. I don't ever intend to be OP'd on this server, not unless I absolutely have to be, and I'd rather not be. By cheat, I mean I went back to my old place and grabbed a whole bunch of stuff. One of those things is my, flying ring that I created, my angel ring, because, you know, building shit is just a hell of a lot easier if you can fly. And I got sick of mining crap, so I just grabbed a whole bunch of stuff from here, or from over there, so now I have a whole bunch of stuff that doesn't go in there. That's for all meltable metals. Well, I guess emeralds are meltable, aren't they? No. But, yeah. So, I have a whole bunch of stuff that I grabbed. So, now I have access to all kinds of crap. And I can build things. So, what I want to do today is attempt to build a tree farm. So, basically a way to chop these things down that I don't have to do manually. And that involves the harvester, I believe it's called. I haven't planned this episode out, like, at all. Yes, it involves the harvester and the planter. Oh, look, a slime fell down on my barn. On my soon-to-be barn. Boop. Hi, sheep. There's a slime on your head. Boop. Okay. I have so many slime balls because of that thing. I don't want to take it down. anyways, what was I saying? Yes, harvester. And the harvester, I need power. And if you're really going to be doing a Glitchcraft kind of thing and, you know, trying to get infinite goods and such, you need to start with infinite power. That is the best way to start for infinity, and that's power. And we have a few options when it comes to that. We have solar power here. Let's see. We have solar flux gives us solar panels and a whole bunch of different types of solar panels. They can actually be upgraded. Let's see. That's still solar flux. We have Project Red solar panels, which I don't think would give us what we want. We have the mechanism generator solar panels, the solar generators and the advanced solar generators. I made like an entire power station off of solar generators over there. So they don't provide that much power. So I'm going to go with the solar flux generators this time just to see what happens. Boop. Okay. Clicky. And yeah, let's start there. Hi. And see how hard are these things to make. These are the generic solar panels, and they require a mirror, which is glass and iron, redstone, and a whole shit ton of wood. Is it easy? Yeah, just wooden planks. So a bunch of glass. Yeah, a bunch of glass, bunch of iron, bunch of wood, and bunch of redstone. Well, shit, that's easy. Do I have that much sand is a question, though. I have 18 glass to start with. Do I have sand? Sand would be in storage shed. Bloop. Not there. Not there. There. Okay. I have a little bit of sand. We can cook up some sand. Yeah, I have plans for all of this. Bloop. Not there. Not there. Oh, yeah. I got sick of not having food, so I kind of made my infinite chicken farm thingamabob underground, and now I have chicken. It's not fast, but it works. All right. I should have plenty of iron. Nope. Here. Yes. Okay. And somehow I have bricks. Let's just put those away. Like I said, I haven't really planned this episode out as far as I probably should have. So I'm going to be just kind of winging it. Boop. What do I have a lot of? I have a lot of spruce wood. Spruce wood is easy. That turtle that's sitting there, that was actually my turtle to gather spruce wood. I wrote a program for it where basically it would plant a tree and then it would sit there and wait until the tree grew and then chop down the tree. Because I don't have any bone meal. I don't have any bones. I'm out of bones. So, yeah. Let's see. Oh, I still need redstone. I have lots of redstone. Actually, mine most of that redstone, except the redstone blocks. I mine the rest of the redstone. So that gives me some wood planks. That'll get me some iron ingots. Glass. Whoop. Wait, what the hell? I am now confused. So, solar panel. Oh. I am no longer confused. I'm just an idiot. Redstone. Mirrors. Wood planks. Oops. And there we go. Now we have solar panels, and they generate 2. Capacity 50. Whatever that means. I don't know to what. I actually don't know. All right. So now we have a solar panel. I'm not 100% sure which direction to go from here. Like I said, I haven't really planned all of this. And where I'm going to put this stuff is just going to be completely temporary. Because I plan on building a place. All right, so it's generating RF. Okay, so it's generating RF, and it said it generated, yeah, 2 RF per tick. Okay, I can work with that. It's not a lot of RF, but I can work with that. So let's move on to the harvester. The harvester uses 240 RF per work. That's a lot of power, isn't it? What can I do with that? That is a lot of power. That takes up a lot of power. What about the other solar jet panels? Weren't they better? Like, I know if I get the Mark 6 solar panels, they go absolutely apeshit. Oh, apparently we need to work our way down, but we need so many other things to do it, too. Like, crazy amounts of things. Holy crap. Wow, that actually looks like a giant pain in the ass. All right, what else? Ooh, okay, so we need those and those, and those aren't easy, and nothing... None of this is easy! And it doesn't say how much they generate per tick. Oh, hold shift and M. Don't tell me shit. All right, well, that's what I'm going to go off for right now. I'm probably doing this in the wrong order. So, actually, once I get this started, I could probably use this setup to generate infinite power. Okay, I have... Yeah, I should have enough stuff to do all of this. Boing, boing, boing. Let's see, so rubber. Where do I keep rubber? Would it be in here? No, it's not in here. That means it's in the storage shed. Boop. There. Not there? There we go. Okay, so take some raw rubber. Whee. I guess I can also make more solar panels easily enough, huh? I mean, that's kind of what I'm doing right here. Holy crap, I've forgotten how slow these furnaces are. There's so much stuff I could make to make my life easy. I guess I'm just going to wait a few moments. I'll gather up the supplies. I'll cook up my raw rubber. And then I'll just come back, because seriously, this is going to take forever if I waited for the glass. And there, I think we have what we need to make what we want to make. I think. Because we need to make a planter. And we need to make a harvester. Boop. Yeah, okay, so now we have a planter and we have a harvester. Boop. I took a bunch of glass and I made a few more solar panels, so not a lot still, but something. And they act weird. They, like, when they're all connected together, they're acting as one. So they're kind of like these four were already largely charged, but when I plugged in the other ones, these ones discharged and filled the other ones, helped fill the other ones. So now they're all like even. So I thought that was really weird. But it should all be the same in general. Let's plunk down a harvester. Do I have to be facing the harvester? No, I have to be going away from the harvester. But one way or the other. Do I have... No, that's an iron hammer. I need... At mine factory... Where are you? Oh, I can never find anything in here. I can't remember what it's called either. Well, I think I know what it's called, but I'm not 100% sure. There it is. Precision sledgehammer. Which means I need more plastic sheets. And some sticks. Conveniently, I'm cooking that stuff still. Boop. Boop. My heart sideways. Boop. Yeah, I keep getting yellow hearts because King Slimes keep falling off of the slime island there and getting stuck in the river. So I keep, like, killing them. I think it's hilarious, honestly. Alright, so that gives me the plastic sheets I need. I can eat a couple sticks. Boop, boop. And a boop. And now we have a precision sledgehammer. Along with a bunch of other things I don't need in my inventory. So from here, I should be able to... Yes, I can see where it is. And I can turn it around. Thank you. Boop. And I need a two deep there so I can put the planter in there. I also need power. And I'm not 100% sure how I'm going to do that yet. Are you getting power? Are you getting power? So the harvester is getting power and the planter needs power. How hard are those universal cables to make? Universal. Basic universal cables, steel, and redstone. All right, how does one go about making steel? Way too much pain in the ass. Try something else. Nope, still wants pig iron. Looks like I need an induction smelter. I need an induction smelter for that. I think, yeah, iron and pulverized coal would make steel. Do I have any steel? I don't think I... Did I grab any steel? I don't remember. I don't think I did. Boop. I have dark steel. Invar. Block of steel. Hey, that works. Yeah, okay, so I'm cheating. I don't care. So, steel, redstone, that makes 8. This should be enough. 3.2 kilojoules per tick. Way more than either of those machines use. So it should be plenty. Plop. To plop that down. And a boom. And now we have power. At least we're generating power. Now I need pipage, which I have. Let's see, pipe. I just had a sudden realization that the harvester is a very bad place. I apparently don't have any more ducts left. Temp duct. It's like simply lead and... What? Lead and tin. I have one tin left here. Put you back. Lead. And... tin. Wait, that didn't look like tin, but that was tin. All right, whatever. All right, so that gets me a whole bunch of item ducts. Do I have any servos left? Would I know where I put them if I had them? I bet you I know where some item ducts actually are now that I think about it. Yeah, right there. So, servo. And item ducts, yeah. I still had that stuff left over. All right, so... I need to move the harvester, now that I think about it. I really, really do. Which I think I can do with the... You're going to make me go to sleep, aren't you? Okay, that'll work. Yep, okay, I can pop them. Ooh, I can pop like everything. Oh, I can, holy crap. You can pop everything with this precision sledgehammer. Boop. Then again, sledgehammers, you know, that tends to suggest you're able to, you know, break things. All right, let's move this out 2 blocks. That'll keep it, or that will still keep it outside of the range of the, or outside of the barn, but it shouldn't be a problem. All right, so harvester goes that way. That gives me space behind it to work. Planter goes... Oh, I wanted the planter here. That means the harvester needs to be one more over. Oh, right. I was like, why am I still seeing the thing? Yeah, that's because... Yeah. All right, so now they overlap. And I can break these again. I'm going to need to make more basic cable, aren't I? Nope, apparently not. All right, so now we have power. Lots of it. What is that 0 out of 5,000 RF? That confuses me. Of course, these solar panels confuse the hell out of me, too. Eh, I don't get it. Oh, wait, I don't need you yet. I want a chest here, right? Yeah, I want a chest there. Again, haven't planned this out. Not well, not as well as I probably should have. That should give me enough. Oh, I had plenty to begin with, actually. Gives me 2 little chests. I want regular chests because I am going to do this now. That gives me 2 iron chests. I could upgrade them even further, but I don't feel like it. Kind of not needed for what I'm doing at the moment. Plop. Alrighty. Now let's dig down here. Get me my item ducts. Then our servo will go here. Set to always on. I need a filter. How do I make filters? I don't remember how I make filters. What I could actually use is a frickin' resonant filter. But I can't make enderum ingots yet, or, pardon, glass yet. Iron nuggets, glass. What about you? Invar ingots, glass, paper, and iron nuggets. How about you? Electrum and hardened. Okay, so the best I can do is invar, glass, paper, and nugget. The higher tier of filter that you use, the more things you can put in as the filter. And if I want to do this right, I'm going to need a lot of things. Do I have paper already made by chance? I do not. Whee. Oh, and I need iron nuggets. Which apparently I've had since the last time I did this. What else do I need? Glass, paper, iron nuggets. No, Invar ingots. So, paper. Ooh, paper goes there. Glass goes there. No, other way around. There we go. Invar and iron nuggets, and that makes me my hardened filter. Whee! Yeah, this should work. I don't see why it wouldn't. Bloop. And then I set that as a whitelist. Get my saplings. And I'm worrying about acacia saplings right now. Those aren't saplings. Those are. You know, now that I think about it, I have no idea if I'm pronouncing acacia properly. Not a clue. All right, so acacia saplings go there. So now the only thing that can ever go into the planter is the acacia saplings. For right now, anyways, I can adjust that later when I want to add other things. So, boop. All right, so it's firing them off three at a time. And when they get to the planter, they should, there it goes, it plants. Should have enough to fill the entire thing. How much power do we have left? Still 27. All right, that fills it. All right. No bones left over from the skeleton, but that was a lot. That was a while ago, so that's probably long since 5 minutes. So no bone meal. I don't think anyways. Hang on. Do I have any bones? I don't think I do. I think I used them all when I was trying to make dark wood. No, spruce wood. That's it. No, no bones. Hmm. Well, they should work. I don't see why it wouldn't. Probably not going to be enough power to run this system for long, but it should run it long enough that I can get wood out of it and turn it into a, or get another generator going. What kind of generator we have? We, the thermal expansion, I think. Steam dynamo. Yeah, steam dynamo I could use. Magmatic dynamo, I would need lava. Compression dynamo, I have no idea. Reactant dynamo, no idea. Enervation dynamo, which I believe I need liquid enderum, or at least ender pearls. All right, so I can make a steam dynamo. Does it tell me how fast it creates? Generates RF, requires water and solid fuel, which I would use wood for. But it doesn't say how much. Like, it doesn't say how much it outputs. Now, I'll have to do some research on that one to see what I get. That's just going to take too damn long. I hate waiting for trees to grow. But I don't have one of those time things. Like, there's a thing you can make with those unstable ingots or whatever it is. It accelerates time. It accelerates the ticks for your plants. So if you sit one, if I sat one like on here, and powered it, of course, it would accelerate time and the plants would grow faster. Which reminds me, I have one more thing I need to do. I need to make a trash can. Specifically, a fluid trash can, which means I need a bucket and a trash can. All right, and trash cans are cobblestone, which I'm carrying, smooth stone, which I'm not. Whee! All right, cobblestone is like that, and smooth stone is like that, and that's not what I need to make. Oh, and I apparently need a chest. Regular chest. And whoop. And there we go. We got a regular, or we got a trash can. And I need a liquid trash can. Which I guess you put the bucket in the trash can, I guess is what is suggested here. I guess. But what you got to do, the reason you got to do that is because the harvester will build up sludge. And I think you can use the sludge for stuff, but I tend to just chuck it, make it go away. So sit the fluids trash can on top of the harvester. The sludge automatically goes into the fluids trash can, and you don't have to worry about it. Problem solved. Whoop. Hey, there it goes. Wow, that didn't kill the power as fast as I thought it would. It's not rebuilding power that fast, but it's not draining as fast as I feared it would. So this is going to run slow, but it's getting me wood. So that'll work. I'm debating on if I want to just move the chunk loader. I think I just want to move the chunk loader. For server sake, I'm limiting how many chunks I use. Like how many chunks I keep loaded. Wow, that chunk is really far away. And I would guess that I would have to keep it. Yeah, because the chunk ends here. All right, so leave that on two. Man, I can barely see those lasers. But it should be enough. I guess that's just 16 extra blocks. That seems to be a lot longer than just two chunks, but whatever. All right, and then that way the chunk loader is running, so I can run off and do other things while the harvester does its thing, and the solar panels can do their thing. And like I said, initially, the harvester is going to be slow because it's not because the solar panels just don't have enough power. I guess that really all depends on the saplings. If the saplings grow faster than the solar panels work, which it actually doesn't look like it so far. If the saplings grow faster than the solar panels work, then everything will be slowed down because the solar panels can't produce enough power. But if they don't grow faster, which so far it doesn't look like it, then the solar panels will be able to produce enough power to run the harvester at a relatively decent pace. It'll still drain the energy fairly quickly, chopping down the trees, but it shouldn't be a problem. I guess we'll have to see. But hey, I actually feel kind of bad that that's all I fucking did. But at this point, it's just, you know, just me screwing around, I guess. Because once you get to the point where you can make, like, diamond stuff, you know, once you can get diamonds, so, what is that? Bronze pickaxe gets you, yeah, bronze levels up to redstone. Redstone level gets you diamonds. Then once you get diamonds, make your ass a mining turtle. You need, obviously, computer craft, but make your ass a mining turtle and mine the shit out of places. And then all of a sudden, you got yourself obsidian, you know, wicked amounts of obsidian, diamonds, just about everything, almost everything. You can't get, I think, titanium. Yeah, no, and that yellowrium. You can't get yellowrium or titanium this way. Oh, yeah, the solar panels are definitely producing power faster. I mean, they aren't anymore because the light level's going down because the sun's setting. But they're definitely producing power during the day faster than the harvester can suck it up. All right, so yeah, gonna end the episode here. And so I will see you guys in the next episode. And as always, keep playing the game and have fun. And I think in the next episode, we're gonna work on the sheep farm. That way we actually get something done. Something progressive. Woohoo!